of Jesus, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus. I throw a wall of fire in the name of Jesus, my God and my Father. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you, Father. We acknowledge your name, God, my Father. I destroy every activities of the devil. I destroy powers of darkness. I destroy anything the enemy is using to bring destruction against this prayer in the name of Jesus. My Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we welcome you. We thank you, Father. I call upon your presence, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray divine protection, my God, my Father. Your word says you have given us power against works of the enemy, against the devil, against their demons, against the serpent and scorpion. Nothing's by all means and utters. My Father, believe your word. I trust your word. No weapon of the enemy shall prevail. No demon from the pit of hell shall construct any evil against anyone. In the mighty name of Jesus, my God, I call upon you. I call the fire of God to destroy and dismantle any powers of darkness, any evil, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God, I want to thank you, Father. I commit every one of us. I commit people, the people in Periscope and prayer line, Lord, I commit your people into your hand, God. My Father and my God, every demon, every evil, every witchcraft following anyone to prayer line, to Periscope, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. Every attack of the enemy, I silence you. I bind you and destroy you in the name of Jesus. Father, I want to thank you. Lord, I want to lift your name up. I want to glorify your name. I thank you, Father, because you are able. You are able, God. You are able, my Father. In the name of Jesus Christ. Rapa papa shitoro robo kura papa pashanta. Rapa papa shitara raba kuria ndere raba shitoro robo kuria. Remba papa shantoro raba kuria ndara raba kuria. Rapa papa shantoro raba kuria. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to bless your name. I thank you, Jesus. You are able, God, mighty God, King of glory. I thank you. I thank you, Jesus. Rapa papa shitoro raba kuria. Rapa papa shantoro raba kuria. Robo baba shantoro raba kuriandere raba solo robo kuria. Robo baba shotoro robo kuriandere raba sala raba kuria. Ramba baba shitoro robo kuriamba baba shantoro raba kuria ba. Orebe baba shantara raba kura baba shantoro raba kura ba. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I praise your name. I pray, God Almighty, in the name of Jesus Christ, I want to thank you, Father. I am praying there's somebody who is having cold, and this cold is very strange. You are like suffocating. You feel like something is suffocating your throat. Your voice is gone. I rebuke that demon to get out of your throat right now. In the name of Jesus, I curse you, demon. Get out of that throat. Get out in the name of Jesus. I curse you right now in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Father, I thank you. I rebuke you, the demon that is hiding in that throat. Get out now in Jesus' name. Yes. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God, I thank you. I thank you. Yes. If you are the one, say amen. You have been set free. And there's somebody that is feeling something is running in his body, in her body. She's a woman. It's a woman. That something is running up. When we started the prayer, you are being disturbed. You want to go, but you are saying, let me see what they are saying. Let me destroy that serpent and demon. Get out of that body in the name of Jesus. They have been provoked there. Now they are manifesting and they are running all over. Some of you feel like you are sick. You want to throw. You feel like you become more sick. You can't take it. You feel like you want to run away. I'm telling you, the devil is a liar. You are not going anywhere. You will stay in Jesus' name. I see other people, they are chanting against me. I am warning you by the power and the blood of Jesus. If you cannot repent, you will go. God is against you. Don't try to chant against me. Don't curse me. I am speaking the right word against you. I pray fire of God, receive fire, start ringing the fire of God and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. I destroy you, charms and chants. You are a liar. Get out from the rhyme in the name of Jesus Christ. Your spells and charms will go back to your head and destroy you in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. Arrows of witchcraft, I fire you back to the sender. Arrows of witchcraft, I fire you back right now. It cannot prosper in my life. It cannot prosper anybody in this prayer, in prayer line, in periscope, in computers, in all everything we are doing. Your witchcraft is not going to prosper. I destroy them in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Whew, hallelujah. Glory be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I want to welcome everyone. Thank you for coming. Thank you. Thank you for joining. God bless you. And tonight I'm going to talk a very sensitive topic, which is called bewitchment and satanic arrows attacks. Bewitchment and satanic purets attacks. I'm going to read from the book of Galatians. Galatians 3 verse 1. The Bible says, "O foolish Galatians, who had bewitched you that you should not obey the truth before whose eyes Jesus Christ has been evidently set forth crucified among you?" Paul is asking, Galatians, who had bewitched you that you should not obey the truth? You know, when people are witched, they cannot obey the truth. They don't know the truth because they are witched. Now Paul is saying, Paul used the word bewitchment to describe the act of being led away into evil doctrine. And because the Galatians were bewitched, he referred to them as being foolish. He said, "Oh, foolish Galatians, who had bewitched you that you should not obey the truth before whose eyes Jesus Christ had been evidently set forth crucified among you?" You know, there is powers of witchcraft, and witchcraft, it works to people. That's why Paul was saying, "Why you foolish? Why you become foolish now? Why do you want the witchcraft to witch you?" Paul is asking them a question. This was a big question Paul was asking, because normal people cannot do what they were doing. Now Paul watched them and see these people have been witched. Therefore, who has witched them? Where did the witch get access to witch the Galatians? Who has witched you? Who? Even you now. Even I ask, who has witched? Who has witched you? Why is nothing is working for you? It seems that the witch has witched you. This is what Paul was saying these people were doing. Bewitchment is when someone uses evil power like witchcraft to charm, to enslave, or to mislead a person. These evil powers can be used on a person, a place, or a thing. Wicked people issue curses on good and innocent people who have not done anything wrong to them. Very innocent. And especially now, they are initiating young children. At the age of 4, the child is already a witch. And this child, the children, they don't have mask. They can kill people. They can destroy people. They have no mask. They are dangerous and grown up. When Paul looked at this, he said, "Wow, who has witched you?" Yeah? So, wicked people, they issue curses on a good and innocent people who have not done anything to them. It does not matter whether you have committed an offense or not before they decide to curse you. Some people, they ask me, "Why? What did we do? Why are we be like this? What did I do to a witch to witch me?" Some people, they ask me a question. I said, "There is nothing you have done. You have not done anything." Hallelujah.
Muted.
You have not done anything. So you find that a witch can come and start witching you. You have not done anything. You have not done, don't worry yourself that you have done anything. That's why the witch is witching you. The mere fact that you have decided to make progress in life makes you their target. The moment you start making progress in your life, you will become a target. I was praying with a sister. I don't know if this sister is on the line. Sister Judith, are you on the line?
Can I hear?
Judith.
Please?
Is Judith in the line?
Hello, is anyone here?
Yes, Sister Judith, are you on the line?
Hello?
Yes?
Hello?
Hello, Judith?
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes.
Are you on the prayer line? Yeah, I can't hear her anymore. Neither can I.
You can't hear anybody?
It was a long beep.
Can you hear me now?
I think she's back. Maybe not yet. Sophistus, are you back?
Okay. Go ahead, Sister Judith.
My name is Diana Baker.
We lost Sophistus.
Uh-oh.
Okay. Can you hear me? Can you hear me now?
Okay.
Hello?
Oh, that might be her.
Hello?
Yeah, that's
her. Can you hear me now?
Yeah,
I can.
All right, Sister Judith, are you on the line?
My name is Diana Baker.
Okay, no problem. I'm looking for Sister Judith. Okay, she's not there. Maybe she's on the Periscope.
Judith? Where is she?
Yeah, this is Sister Judith.
No problem. This is a sister. Okay, are you on?
Yes, I am.
Okay, can you give a testimony?
Yeah, praise the Lord. I've got so much to be thankful for. Two weeks ago, I was having some problems at work. I was having chest pains, and I called Pastor Christine and asked her if she could pray for me, which she did. And when you told me that you saw my situation that I was having at work and that was causing me to have chest pains, and you prayed for me and you used scriptures to prophesy over me also, and you told me that the issue at work was going to be, it's going to be a problem, the person that's trying to cause me problems, it will be resolved, and also that you saw that I'm not going to be having any chest pains. And so last week Friday when I came back from being away, I actually was having another issue that came up with my son, and I was also having the same issue came back with my chest, and I went to the hospital. You prayed with me again, and you said I should, stop stressing because you see my heart and it's open and I'm fine. There's nothing wrong with my heart. Well, today I went to see the cardiologist, and they did a stress test on me, which is a test that stresses out the heart to see if there's any problems there. And the doctor said that my heart is it's good. There's no problem. I don't have any cardiac problems as far as he's concerned. So I got a clear bill of health. And also, you also prophesied about my son. You said that you saw my son, when we were praying, you saw like a gun at his head. And you prayed for it not to be so. And what happened was my son usually goes into the hospital and he's escorted by the police. But what happened was the police, when they escorted him, they actually beat him up. And I, believe that if you had not prayed, they may have done something more harmful to him. And so, everything that you prophesied over me and prayed with me for has actually come true, exactly the way that you saw it, the way the Lord showed you. And I just want to praise God for you and thank him for you. and I'm really happy to have gotten to know you. I'm sorry about my voice. I'm just tired. I've been busy, so busy today. But yes, that's yeah.
Amen.
So thank God again.
Amen. Thank you, sister. This is the sister. She called me from workplace. She had trouble at work, and the same time she was sick. She had a problem with the heart, and she had a pain in the chest. When you have pains in the chest, you know they suspect maybe it's the attacker, is a heart attack or something. So I saw when I prayed for her, I saw there's nothing wrong with her heart because I saw her heart clear, open, and nothing was there. So I told her there's nothing. You go to the doctor, they will find there's nothing. And also about his her son, I saw a gun pointing at his head. So when I prayed, I said, I see a gun, but let's pray that that would not happen to him. We prayed. Now, she was telling me that she was beaten by police, maybe something could have happened bad, worse than that. But we thank God the son is alive and is safe. We give God glory because there's nothing happened without God revealing to his servants. So I want to tell you that bewitchment, this woman, she has just finished her PhD. What did you finish? PhD for what? Judith, you finished PhD for what? What did you finish PhD for?
I can't hear you, sorry.
You have just, you have graduated your PhD.
Oh, this is psychotherapy.
Yes.
Psychotherapy, yes, counseling.
Okay, she has just graduated PhD in psychotherapy and counseling. Yes. Now, the enemy has raised jealousy. The witchcraft, they have just started envying her. They started fighting, sending arrows everywhere. Sending arrows, attacking our work, attacking our health, attacking our children, everything. That's why I'm telling you that witchcraft is bad. Wicked people issues curses on good people and innocent people who have not done anything wrong to them. The woman has worked very hard. She had she has acquired her paper, clinic papers. She works very, she's a professional, she's a nurse. Now she has done everything. Then the wicked, they have seen that she's going to prosper, she's going to progress. Now they are sending arrows to her. They could have killed her.
Yes.
Yeah? But God is good.
Yes.
God is good.
Amen.
Attacking their victims, that use also various. You know, they use what we refer as satanic puppets or demonic idols after people, while some just subjugated their victim in their dreams. You see, these wicked people, they are so wicked, they don't want to see anybody doing any progress. The moment you start progress like this, the moment you start a store, you start working, they will send arrows, they will send their bullets in dreams, they will attack you so hard. But the good news is that Jesus Christ is able. I will destroy them in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Bewitchment is a common local satanic technology. What does it mean to bewitch? It is to bring continually evil on a person. To bewitch is to charm a person using satanic power or to put a person under spell using satanic powers. Bewitched people operate under an evil control. They will not listen to good counsel. When you are being witched, you are controlled by those evil. You do mistakes. You make mistakes because you are being controlled and you don't listen. They are always involved in errors and do the wrong things. Usually, their minds are close to the truth. A sister went to somewhere to pray, and the man of God there said, you have a special problem, so you need a special prayer. You know, people, they call me. When you are looking for help, you call people because you are looking for help. Now, here is a sister who was in need of prayer. He needed the prayer. He called this man so-called a man of God. And when the man of God received the call, he said, yes, you have a special problem, so you need special prayer. And the sister said, any prayer point you give me, I would pray it. But the so-called special prayer turned out something else, as she was told to stand on a mount on mortar, naked. This is the true story. Even one of my daughter was telling me exactly this story is the same. She was told to stand on a mortar, naked, and hold a candle in her hand until it melts out. The hot mortar fox running down her hands, notwithstanding. Sometimes, some of you people, you have gone to some places like that, where you are told to stand or to be washed, or to be washed with a sponge or with something. Now, this sister, while this demonic prayer was going on, the man of God, the man which was called himself the man of God, was running his hands on her naked body. You know, you are a man and a woman, and now you are naked in front of the man. What do you expect? Now the man was running his hand on his naked body. At the end of the prayer, she swear never go back there. But the next day, she was back to that demonic man and his demonic prayer. Why? She had been witched. You know, when you are witched, you make mistakes. You say, I will never go to that church again. Tomorrow you are there. I will never call that pastor again. You call him again. When you are put on spells and witched and bewitched, that's what happened. That's what happened to Galatians. When Paul looked at them and said, who has witched you? Bewitched person would experience continuously confusion of the mind. A bewitched person would experience continually confusion of the mind, continuously tirelessness, nervousness, distressed, disjointed thoughts, sense of emptiness, and loss of self-control, all because he is obeying a strange command. He may be having continuously accident, loss of income, loss of position, loss of reputation, affliction with diseases and pain. You know, I don't know if you heard me saying this testimony all the time. I used to get a lot of accidents. I lost everything. Yeah? Affected with the sickness and the diseases. When you are being bewitched, you are always being affected with sickness and diseases. Everything you do, you lose your income, your job, everything you have. Continual accident. You do things that you are not supposed to do. You find you have done it. The book of John 4 verse 18 says that, for you have the five husband, and the one whom you are now is not your husband. In that you speak truth. Now, here is the woman who had five husband. She was trying to get married. Everybody come and use her and leave her. Everyone come and use her and leave her. When you are bewitched, that is what happened. You cannot have a husband who loves you. Everybody is coming to you, use you and go. Use you and go. This is pure bewitched. This woman, she wanted a husband, and she tried. All five men, they were using him. They were using her and go. There was a man who married 19 wives, and each of them died after 3 months. But the women were still coming. The women were still coming. And the foolish guys were heard of what happened to their predecessors. Still went ahead and married the man, or because the car he was using enticed them. You know, this man married 19 women. All of them died. And the women never realized that. Why is the women dying? Why should we go there? Because there was witchcraft in them. They did not know that the cars were certificate of death. But when he married the 19th wife, he met the Lord and the bondage was broken. That is what we call bewitchment. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. There was still a need for a proper deliverance to be to be contacted on her. This is where some ministers messed it up. There is a time Jesus was speaking in the temple. The priest, stop talking. Hallelujah.
Unmuted.
Yes. Hallelujah. Presbyter, name of Jesus.
Yes.
Unmute your phone, please. Jesus was teaching and the demonic man interrupted him, saying, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to torment us before our time? We know who you are, the only one of God." Then they knew who he was, but the priest did not know. Then what happened? Jesus abandoned his teaching for a few seconds and deal with him. If teaching would have removed the unclean spirit from the man, yes, this is the story about Jesus was teaching and a man interrupted them. He started saying, "Jesus, we know you." Yeah, he wanted to fool Jesus so that Jesus would say, "Okay, this man knows I am the child of God. I am the child of God." But Jesus, when this man started interrupted with him, Jesus stopped preaching. Jesus said, What am I hearing?" He went straight away and they rebuked the demon. He said, "Come out of him." So Jesus contacted the deliverance on the people straight away. So those who are bewitching people are called witches. In the book of Psalm 69, verse 23 to 28, the Bible says, when you look at this, this is what we come against witchcraft. We come against people who are witching others. Psalm 69, verse 23 to 28, the Bible says, "Let their eyes be darkened, that they see not, and make their runs continually to seek. Pour out their indignation upon them, and let their wrathful anger take hold on them. Let their habitation be desolate, and let none dwell in their tents. For they persecute him whom they had smote, and they talk to the grave of those whom he has wounded, and the iniquity unto their iniquity. Let them not come unto the righteousness. Let them be brought out of the book of the living, and not be written with the righteousness." You see, this is what we say. Today, all the witches shall be disgraced and shall flee out of their habitation in Jesus' name. I advise that if you are not interested in breaking the head of serpents, then this message is not for you. Because whosoever is friendly with the enemy, the fire of the God of Elijah shall fall on him in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that God Almighty, as this scripture says, Psalm 69, verse 23 to 28, there is a lot of prayer points from these scriptures. We pray that every witchcraft, any witchcraft that is working against you, let their eyes be darkened, that they may see not. Let their eyes be blind, let their eyes go blind. And witchcraft using the eyes to witch you, let their eyes be black in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that everyone who is being tortured, tormented by witches, every problem that you are facing you from witchcraft, I am praying that let them be darkened. Let them, their eyes be dark, and let them be slavery in the name of Jesus. All the witches shall be disgraced and shall flee out of their habitation in Jesus' name. I would advise that if you are not interested in breaking the head of serpents, then this message is not for you. Because whosoever is friendly with our enemies, the fire of God of Elijah shall fall on him. And every instrument of bewitchment must be roasted today in Jesus' name. We are going to pray with the anger, holy madness, and violent faith like this. Every instrument of bewitchment be roasted in the name of Jesus. That is how you are going to pray. You pray every instrument of bewitchment be roasted. Let their instrument be roasted in Jesus' name. when a man witched, he cannot start. When a man is witched, he can start building, he will never complete. He can start this and this, he started this, he live a halfway. He can construct a house, he leave this house and he go to start another one. He can go to start a business and leave the other one. He can go and look for another business, even to buy a land, and still he can't complete. All the time, they would never complete anything. They start this and this and live halfway. When they are being witched, when a person is bewitched, always he tried this, he tried that, but nothing is working for him. That even jobs, you can find the person is going everywhere. This, when he go to a job, he goes there, he worked few months, he left the job, he goes like that. That is bewitchment. The person like that, he may start walking about without even wearing a pair of shoes or slippers or sandals. He will still trying to buy a land to start yet another project. He has been bewitched. When you see somebody like that, he has been bewitched. A land can be witched. Once a land is bewitched, no business will prosper there until the bewitchment upon it is broken. If a land is bewitched, even if you plant crops there, they will not do well. The reason many people find it difficult to complete their houses is because they are building them on the bewitched land. You have seen some people, even anywhere, you see they can start a building, but the building will never complete. They complete it because the land is bewitched. There is some community who are poor. You know, no matter what you can do, because their community has been witched, the city has been witched. Witchcraft has put a witch there, so nothing will work there. That is why sometimes we advise people to boil oil on such a places. What happens when you boil oil on such a land is that the farmer, the place will prosper. We have special oil. Old oil, we pray for that oil. Wherever you are going to do business, even if you go to a new place, office to work, take your oil and anoint that office so that you can stay there. Because some wicked have planted evil things, then you can't work there. Some wicked have dedicated the place. When you go there, you will not stay, you will go. They will tell you many people have come here, they go. Come and go. And them, they are there. You know, this is wicked. They are wicked and wickedly. When you anoint the doorpost of your house with oil, if somebody who has demon is coming in, his demon will wait for him. When he gets to the door, while he enters, he goes out. He carries it again before he go away. So that's why you need anointing oil. Anointing oil, it stops, the Bible tells us, it casts out the demons. Those witchcraft, when you have the anointing oil, when you meet them, the anointing oil will chase them. That's what it happened. That's what Jesus was telling his disciples, to use the oil. You use the fire of God. You use the word of God to stop them, because they can witch you. Paul was talking about the Galatians. Who has witched you? Because there is witchcraft. Who can witch people and people become stupid, become fools? An educated person. I know a professor, one of our professors, she was in America. She was a professor in America University. Now she had troubles, she had problems. Then she was told, go home. And she went home to this witch person, witchcraft doctor. And the witchcraft told this woman, the best way to get this problem off, just curl the pot on your head naked at midnight. Walk around the street on with the pot. Then the woman said, I'm American. How can I do that? There's no way you can treat me apart from that. I said, no, that's the only problem you can solve. The woman was calling that pot naked, a professor in one of the universities in America, because of the problem, because of witchmen. And that was witching, that was more witching. How can you be told by a man to walk naked in the street while you are calling a pot, so that problem can go? That is witchcraft. They had you more witchcraft. Therefore, any witchcraft in your family, in your spirit, attacking you, make you to be a fool, let that witchcraft die in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yes, Lord. Amaretic could be witched. Immediately after the wedding, there will be no money or business progress would stop. Even good things would stop and bad things would start to happen. The marriage has been witched. Bewitchment is therefore a very wicked satanic weapon that believers should not treat with respect. It is a product of work of witches that has turned so many people to blind men in the streets. They have held up many people from progressing. They bewitch people by locking up their prosperity with demonic people by locking up their prosperity with demonic lock. Such a people can only be set free in Jesus' name. You know your money can be witched. They can give you money. You think this money is good. Somebody can give you money. You think this money is good. They are programmed, and once you get this money, you take it to go and you bank to your account, or you use it. That is the when you buy the problem. And the problem will swallow everything you have. It will bedrock everything you have. The only method that can help you is that when you give your tithe and offering to the right place, who will represent your offering to God, it is when you can be delivered. I told somebody, a man, to call me for financial deliverance, because his money was bullied, was taken to the coven, was taken to the grave, so that he can't, whatsoever he tried, nothing would happen to him. That's witchcraft. You don't have to joke with that. Many people have been trapped by what we call midnight gathers, who fed them every night. Sometimes they bring things that such a people do not like eating ordinary, and force feeding them with these things. Sometimes they even wake up and see the faces of the food in their mouths. Sometimes you see food, little food. They feed you. Sometimes they even wake up and see the trace of the food in their mouths. It is the work of witches. There are some specialists in marrying people, and they go from one husband to another in the dream. Some bury people alive in the dream. Such a people normally die in their sleep. They put evil mark on people, and such a people will not be able to move the way others are moving. They perform spiritual operation on people. They may even replace some normal organs with the organs of animal. All these are the work of witches. They render a person friendliness. You found yourself, you have no friend. Nobody wants to hear from you. It is not a good testimony when, as a Christian, you say, I don't have any friend, because all the friends that I had were bad. You yourself say, I don't have friends because all the friends I have are bad. You can't trust, you don't have anybody, you can't have. That's bewitched. That's bewitchcraft. You have been witched. The Bible even called Jesus the friend of sinners. So he has friends. Although too many friends are bad, but if it's not a present testimony for a believer to live life of solidarity, you may not realize it, but you may be, your situation is that people find it difficult, even if it is impossible to get along with you, then you are bewitched. You know, sometimes you find all people are bad. You can't have a friend. You can't talk to anybody. You feel everybody is bad. You are bewitched. The manifestation of their operation at times is as if they give their victim a demonic injection, and the person or object were operating under that influence. They are behind a lot of broken homes. The head of such witches shall be broken today in the name of Jesus. They are ones who put the stamp on multiple husband on people. They sponsor fire for fire quarrel between a sponsor. They put the stamp of multiple girlfriends on some men, just to render them destitute. You know, some men, they are married, but they are cheating. They have so many girlfriends. And also some women, they are married, but you find them, they are cheating. They have so many boyfriends, they have a different husband too. those are witchcraft. That's what happened. Then the marriage is cut and they end up. Such a man might be posting that they are smart and handsome, but the truth of the case is that they are senior project to school of bewitchment. Even women, they think they are smarter than the wife. They are being bewitched and they have no idea. People leave their husband, they go to another city to go and do immorality there, to go and do fornication. They think that is normal. It's not normal. It's bewitched. It's not normal. Wonder of God, I commit these people unto your hands. I pray that every yoke of sin will be broken in his or her life in the name of Jesus. As she or he takes decision now, Lord, I pray that God Almighty deliver your people from bewitchment, deliver your people from witchcraft, deliver your people from being bewitched in the name of Jesus. I'm going to pray that God will help you. We pray that I'm going to pray the prayer, then you pray after me. Where you are in Periscope, I am praying that I cancel every bewitchment against my life in Jesus' name. Pray like this. I cancel every bewitchment against my life in the name of Jesus. I cancel every bewitchment against my life in the name of Jesus. I cancel. You have to cancel every bewitchment against your life in Jesus' name. Cancel every bewitchment against your life in Jesus' name. I say, I cancel every bewitchment against my life in Jesus' name. You know, when you pray, you cancel, you will cancel every witchcraft material in your life, any witchcraft, anything do with the witchcraft in your life, you cancel it. I cancel every witchcraft, every bewitchment in my life and my children in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, your children are bewitched. You have been bewitched. Your husband has been bewitched. The whole household has been bewitched. So you cancel every bewitchment against your life and your children, against your family in Jesus' name. Every tree of bewitchment be rooted up in the name of Jesus. I pray that every tree of bewitchment be uprooted in Jesus' name. Let it be uprooted in the name of Jesus. Witchcraft tree planted in your life, be uprooted in Jesus' name. Be uprooted. I cast out every witchcraft tree in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I breathe the blood of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty will uproot every bewitchment tree in your life in Jesus' name. I paralyze every spirit of bewitchment in your life in Jesus' name. I paralyze every spirit of bewitchment in my life in Jesus' name. You paralyze them. It will not function. It will not work. It will not prosper in Jesus' name. You paralyze them. You have to paralyze them. You command them to die. You command them. They cannot prosper in Jesus' name. Satanic bewitchment, go back to your sender in the name of Jesus. You command satanic bewitchment, go back to your sender in the name of Jesus. Every satanic bewitchment, go back to your sender. Every witchcraft material, go back to your sender. Every arrows of witchcraft, go back to the sender. I fire you back in the name of Jesus Christ. You fire back every witchcraft arrows back to the sender in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will help you in the name of Jesus. Beginning from tomorrow, your life is going to change. And if you have been attacked by satanic bullet, you have been attacked by witchcraft all the time, by tomorrow, your life is not going to be the same again. Your life is going to change in Jesus' name. Every satanic embargo on your handwork be nullified in Jesus' name. I pray that every satanic embargo on your handwork be nullified in Jesus' name. Every satanic witchcraft that is attacking your hands, that is attacking the work of your hand, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. I release you from every bewitchment in Jesus' name. I release you from every bewitchment in the mighty name of Jesus. Any power that wants to attack you as a result of this prayer, I pray that let them be roasted sevenfold in Jesus' name. I pray any power that wants to attack me as a result of my prayer, this prayer point, be roasted, because I know they were trying to attack me. Therefore, I pray anybody will try to attack anybody, anyone in prayer line and periscope, they will be roasted in Jesus' name. I have sent fire to wherever they are in their camp, and they will be roasted in Jesus' name. Witchcraft, receive fire of God and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Witchcraft must die. They cannot touch and torment people, and Jesus Christ has set people free. But they are so wicked. Therefore, I destroy them in the name of Jesus. I pray that let the fire of Elijah fall upon them and burn them to ashes in Jesus' name. Let them be destroyed. You know the scripture called them. Look at that. Meditate that scripture. Psalm 69. Look at Psalm 69, verse 23 to 28. Just get those prayer points from there. The Bible says, let their eyes be darkened. That is how David was praying like that. He said, let their eyes be darkened. Let their ways be go dark, because they will make you dark. They cover your crowd. They make you go dark. So let them go. Whatever they are doing, let them turn back to themselves in Jesus' name. I cover you with the blood of Jesus. I cover you. I seal you with the war of fire. I pray that God will cover you in the name of Jesus Christ. I thank God for your life in Jesus' name. I pray for you and your family in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My Father and my God, I want to thank you. I want to bless you. I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you so much. After the periscope, after the prayer, don't go away. If you want to remain in prayer, to prayer line, I'm going to pray for you. So if you have any prayer request, after the periscope, I will pray with you a little bit before you go. Don't go after we finish. Remember to go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. There is prayer point that I put under the need of YouTube. So if you go there, you get this prayer. People are calling me, they want prayer point. I said they are in the YouTube. Because you don't go there, you want everything to be done. You want everything to be done for you. So go to YouTube and the prayers are there. Help yourself. Hallelujah. Unmute your phone, please. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I thank God for you. And I know that God will help you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. I want to thank God and thank you for coming. Remember to go to our website. Show an amount. If this prayer is helping you, donate an amount. Show this ministry. God will bless you. I pray that God will help you in the name of Jesus. Tomorrow, we will be on midnight. Today, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. 4 nights. So every night we are on, except Friday and Saturday and Sunday. We are not having midnight. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. We don't have midnight. The rest of the days we will have midnight prayer. Because God has told me that we will be doing midnight until the end of the year. We will be doing midnight until the end of the year. That's what we'll be doing now. Unless something happens or I go to the conference, if I'm not in Canada, but life will still continue. God bless you so much. See you tomorrow midnight. But prayer line, don't go. I want to pray with you. Thank you very much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye. Bye-bye to you. Have a good night or a good morning, your country. I don't know what your time over there. God bless you so much. Have a wonderful time. Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye.